Good morning. My name is Kiloshna and I am working as assistant professor under the B department from St. Martin's Engineering College. Now today's topic is about two port network. Two port network, which is the most important topic in electrical circuit analysis. Before discussing about a two-port network and analyzing a two-port network, first let me see the basic definition of what is meant by port. Port is nothing but a pair of terminals. Port is nothing but a pair of terminals where the government main enters. Are leaves where the current may enter or leaves. That we will say as a port. What is meant by port? A port is nothing but it is a pair of terminals where the current may enter or it may leave. The basic element in port, we have single port network and two port network. So if you see a single port, nothing but a single elements, which are nothing but if you take a resistor, it is a single port. Because if, according to the definition, it consists of a pair of terminals where the current is entering to the port and it is leaving from the other terminal. So we will say as a single port. What are the other elements which we have as a single element? This is a single port and this is also a single port network. Okay? Here the network consists of a single element where resistor, inductor and capacitor. So these comes under the example of single port. Now if you see two, according to the definition, we are going to discuss two. What is meant by two? The definition remains same. Port means it is a pair of terminals where the current may enter or leave that terminal. We will say as a port. Here, as we are saying two port, definitely the network consists of two pair of terminals. Here, the network may consist of any type of network. Here, network is represented with a rectangular black box. Right? So, as I said, two port network, here we are consisting of two pair of terminals. It consists of two pair of terminals. They are given the input terminal name as 1, 1 dash and the second pair of terminals as 2, 2 dash. 1, 1 dash and 2, 2 dash. See, according to the definition, there are the two pair of terminals. So, here the first pair of terminals having the output voltage as V1. With respect to voltage current flowing in the input port, I will name as I1. The second put where open voltage will be E2. According to the voltage, the current flowing will be I2. Okay? So this is V1, I1, V2 and I2, which is we are saying this as a two-port network. So coming to the two-port network, here you can see there are two terminals. We are having two terminals and four variables. We are having four variables. What are those four variables? V1, V2, I1 and I2. You can have a doubt that being you are saying it as an output port, why you are showing the current is entering into the port? Actually, once you connect a load, the current has to flow to the load. So the action should be this way. But a standard notation of the port how to be represented in the circuit. If you are considering that is the load, we will write I2 is equal to minus I1. We will connect the load. But standard notation should be I2 how to be represented into the port only. Right? Now, if you take a 4 variable and 2 terminal network, what are the general constants value we are going to get? So if you take the probability constant, if you take, there are the four variables. Out of four, compulsory we know any two sources. This side we will nothing but two variables, and remaining two sources will be depending on this. So in this probability is how many networks, that is how many circuit analysis you are going to get here. So if you take out of four variables in two, if you take a probability, take V1, V2 sources that we know, and I1, I2 are depending on this. And you can take voltage V1 you know, and I1, that is V1 and I2 are the sources, and V2, I1 will be depending on these two. So in this way you are having probability constants. So if you take, we will get 6 parameters. Out of 4 variables, if you are taking probability constant, that is what two considering as a known sources, and other two will come mainly depending on these two sources. So then you will get total 6 parameters. Nothing but the formula which you have is NC2, probability constant, which is 4C. If you do that equation, answer will be 6. Means I am getting 6 parameters for the out of 4 variables by considering 2 as an dependent and 2 as an independent. So first, in this 6, what are the 6 parameters? Z parameters, next one is Y parameters, Z is nothing but impedance parameters, Y is nothing but impedance parameters, next H parameters, which are hybrid parameters, next ABCD parameters, next inverse ABCD parameters, nothing but G parameters. So these are the 6 parameters which you are going to have out of these 4 variables. Well, considering 2 as an independent and other 2 as an dependent. Now let me start from Z parameters. Let me start from calculating Z parameters. So in Z parameters, what I'm going to consider? So I1, I2. Here, voltage V1, V2 are independent sources which depends on the variables I1 and I2. From this, what you can see here, out of 4 variables, what I am going to consider in Z parameters, the V1, V2 are dependent sources on which parameters? I1 and I2. Means here, what are the parameters I know? Current I1 and I2 are the sources I am going to know. So these are independent sources. So Z parameters, the variables I1 and I2 will act as an independent variables, and V1 and V2 will act as an dependent variables. Right? So if, by considering like this, if you write the equation, as I already said, the voltage V1 is a variable depending on I1, nothing but the parameter which is constant value. There will be some parameter constant. So I am considering as Z. Why I am taking Z, you will come to know later by putting the equation Z1 and I1. And again, the V1 parameter is also depending on I2, which is Z1 to I2. Then we have second equation, which is V2. The variable V2 is also depending on I1. With a constant parameter of Z21 plus this V2 is also depending on I2, which is constant value of Z22 to I2. Right? Now write down all the parameters. These are the first and second equation. First and second equation. Now if I want to find the parameters, nothing but the constants of these equations. So how can we calculate? If I want Z11, so Z11 will be equal to V1 by I1, then I2 becomes 0. If you make the second variable current I2 as a 0, then I can find Z11, which is equal to V1 by I1. The same way, when you make I2 0, can you make the second I to 0? Just simply open the circuit. If you open the circuit, the current variable I to will be 0. Hence, there is an across the open terminals, there will be a voltage. So, I have applied V1 across open, and with respect to voltage V1, you will get the current I1 by connecting an ammeter here. You can find the or measure the I1, and if you connect the voltmeter about the second port, you will find V2. So, hence, by getting the V1 value, I1 value, and V2 value, you can find the parameters Z11, Z1. Now let me see the other parameters, which are I, if I want to find Z12. How can we find Z12? Z12 is nothing but it is the ratio of V1 by I2. Then I1 becomes 0. If I1 becomes 0, then V1 by I2 will be, you will get Z12 as a parameter. Same, when I1 becomes 0, see from the second equation, if I1 becomes 0, you can find Z22. How? Z22 is equal to V2 by I2. Z22 is equal to V2 by I2. Then you are making I1 0. Let's see how we can make I1 0. Simply don't connect the first port. Simply open the first port. Now if you open the first port, here there is no current for this port. But there will be an voltage because when there is an open port, the voltage will be existed. So hence current will not flow from 1 to 1 dash. Because your port 1 is open. I am not giving any excitation, just simply open it. So you will come to V1 by connecting an voltmeter here. Due to the excitation given on the second port. So as the excitation I have given over the V2, hence the current is flowing, I2 can be measured with the ammeter. So what are the parameters I am going to get here? I know V2 because I have given the voltage. With respect to the battery V2, I will get current I2. Here I2 is not 0. You will get I2 by measuring through an ammeter. Hence you will get V1. See, if after getting V, you will get V2, I2 and V1 by these three variables, you can find the parameters Z12, Z22. So this is the way how do we calculate the parameters Z11, Z21, Z12 and Z22. Let me see these names. What are the names? See here, the variable V1 by I1 is nothing but both the ratios, both the variables are the input side. So it is the variable, what you are going to do? By open circuit, it is an, you are open circuit in the second port. So it is an open circuit. Driving point is an open circuit. Driving point, input impedance, because both the variables are towards the input side. So we can say it as, it is the ratio of V by I. So input impedance. How can you name it? So it is an open circuit because you are opening the second port. It is an open circuit, driving point, input impedance. Now let me see the Z21. Z21, what is happening? It is also open circuit, but the output here, the second variable, V2 by I1. V2 is the second port variable. I1 is the first port variable. Nothing but output by input. So what you can write? Open circuit. An open circuit. Forward impedance. Because it is output by input variable. Forward impedance. Now if you see the same thing, here it is also open circuit, but what it is? Input by output. So it is not forwarded, it is backward. It is not output by input, input by output. So same way we can write reverse impedance. Output circuit, reverse impedance. Now, Z22, if you see, it is both the variables are from the output terminals only. So how we can write? Open circuit, driving point, output impedance. Open circuit, driving point, output impedance. So these are the names of all the four parameters of the circuit. So this is the way of